But that's the thing, it's the disconnect. That's what it is that there's a disconnect that we have to reconnect.
Yeah.
Because you got Africans who live in America having preconceived notions about Africans that live in Africa. And you have Africans that live in Africa that have preconceived notions about Africans that live in America. When it's like, no, we are the same. You go from here to South Africa, you go over there and you see the same type of racism.
Yeah.
You see the same type of bullshit.
South Africa in particular, the parallels are crazy.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like, I went to Cape Town and I thought I was gonna vomit.
Mm-hmm.
Because I could smell the European piss.
Mm-hmm.
I hate to say that, but that shit is real. Like, and it pisses me off. You know what I'm saying? Like, that is our land.
Mm-hmm.
That is ours. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, let somebody come into your house that you rent, that you don't even own, and try to take your shit. You're going to be like, whoa, excuse me? Excuse me, let me get my clock.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. Like, we have to reconnect with home. Home. Because that is the way that we will complete ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't complete if you don't know where you come from. And there are ways to be complete by reading, by educating yourself. And listen, not everybody is in a position, I'm the first one to understand, not everybody is in a position, and I'm so grateful to be in this position, but not everybody is in a position where they can just travel.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Where they can be like, oh, I'm going to go to South Africa, or I'm going to go to Nigeria, I'm going to go to Kenya. They're not in that position. And we have to acknowledge that, and we have to respect that. There's no excuse not to be educated. There's no excuse not to be educated about your people. There's no excuse not to be educated about where you possibly come from.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So that's just my whole thought about Africa. I think that Africa is, there's something so emotional just about, like, when people say, when everybody's there, they'd be like, is it your first time in Africa? And I'm like, yeah, my very first time. And they'd be like, welcome home. And you just want to cry because you don't feel like that's some thing that they say to tourists. You don't feel corny. Like, you don't feel like that's something that is just some bullshit that they say to tourists. You really genuinely feel like, I was grasping my heart the entire time, just being like, thank you. I'm just so blessed to be here. I'm so blessed to be in your presence. I'm so blessed to be. When you walk down the street and you see the faces of women that have the faces of your mother, oh my God. Oh my God. There's nothing better. There's nothing better in this world. Nothing. And it doesn't matter where I go, it doesn't matter what I do, it doesn't matter who I meet, I know for a fact I have never felt more complete and I've never felt more like me unapologetically when I was there. That's just fact. I'm sorry. So, you know, it is what it is. Go to Africa, man. Go to Africa. It's the way. It's the way. And for everybody that's denying that joint, have fun with your life.
Thank you.
I said a lot.